sharpen my sword, oh Lord. This is how I fight my battles. Spending my time in the wings of your shadows. Ran from your presence, could've swore I was at him. But you brought me back and your hands so fragile. Now I gotta stay patient. When I see your love and your grace so patient. Time after time and you still amaze me. Amazing grace, let the chorus take me away.
Oh,
we'll be right back.
for his presence. Begin to invite him into this space using your own words. Holy Spirit, come inhabit. Come riding on the praises of your people, Lord. We are here, we are open vessels, ready to receive you, Jesus. Holy Spirit, we receive all that you want to do tonight. Whatever that might look like, we're ready. We are here, we are ready for you, Jesus.
Here it is, we give you space. Here it is, we give you space, Holy Spirit. Here it is, we give you space. So honored to have you, to have you, yes, Lord. It's an honor to have you. We're so honored to have you. It's an honor to have you. So we give you space, come and have your way. We give you space, come and have your way. Come and have your way, come and have your way, come and have your way. We give you space, come and have your way. We give you space, come and have your way. We give you space, we give you space, we give you space. We give you space, come and have your way. We give you space, come and have your way. Come and have your way. We give you space. Come and have your way. We give you space. Have your way. We give you space. Come and have your way. We give you space. We give you space.
Awake my soul.
praise aloud. Sing his praise aloud. Changes things, it's the sound of his people on their knees. Awake up, you slumbering, it's time to worship him. Awake my soul and sing his praise aloud. Sing his praise aloud. Oh,
praise aloud, sing his praise aloud. satisfied than this. Some may say it's foolishness, but I become even more undignified than this.
I think we need to shake off our dignity.
And I become even more undignified than this. Oh, some may say it's foolishness, but I become even more undignified than this. Oh, some may say it's foolishness, but I become even more undignified than this. Some may say it's foolishness, but I become even more undignified than this. Oh, some may say it's foolishness, but I become even more undignified than this. Some may say it's foolishness, but I become even more undignified than this.
First time, you can raise your hand. Oh, also, you can sit down. Sorry, I can't see you. If it is your first time tonight, would you raise your hand? And I can't see you. Oh, okay, I see some of y'all. We got like four of you guys. If you have not visited the info booth that was outside, we are after service going to have an info booth in the right hand, this side, left side of the corner. After service, we want to connect with you. We also have a gift for you, so come see us. And then, sorry, also, if it's your first time, if you would text welcome to that number. We just want to get your information. And we also have groups every Thursday night at 7 p.m. at Moravian Coffee. There's a lot of us that go, and it's just been so much fun. And we've been building like a deeper relationships with each other and going after God together. So if you want a different way to connect with the body of Christ and other people, you can come join us. And then to the screen, if you want to look to the screen for the video announcement.
Announcements. First up, you guys already know, we have groups every Thursday at Moravian Coffee at 7 p.m. So gather, join in community, and just grow and learn, get deeper into the heart of the Lord. Next up, if you guys are not already subscribed to our TY podcast, go ahead and do that. The sermons from our last series, Foundations, are live on there, including Gabe's powerful sermon from last week. So go ahead and take a listen. And lastly, we have a big announcement. We're taking a day to head to the zoo. This is going to be on April 27th, so get a couple of your friends, get in the car, meet us there. That's all the announcements for this week. For all things TYA, head to our Instagram at trinitychurch_YA. And don't forget, on Mondays we fast and we honor, serve, and burn together. Peace out.
This one work? Okay, perfect.
Hello.
I don't know about you guys. It's my second time here, and I want to go to the zoo with you because that sounds really fun. So I might be joining you guys with that. My name is Patrick Bell. This is my wife, Samantha Bell.
Hello.
Thank you. We're here to share a little bit about something awesome happening here at Trinity that we would love to invite you guys into. If you guys were here on Sunday, you may have heard Pastor Becky talking about this small group of ragtag people on Thursday nights circling the church and praying into South Dallas becoming a blue zone. And if you don't know what a blue zone is, what this is, it's a place where people are at extremely high odds to live to be 100 plus and be happy and healthy when they do it. There's places in Okinawa, different places in Europe. There's Loma Linda out in California. And inside this small little ragtag group of, I say ragtag, they're actually pretty great crew. We have a Thursday night Kingdom Health class. If any of you guys want to come at 7 o'clock, the Lord just been speaking into this vision that South Dallas is meant to become a blue zone. And this is a 250-year vision that I want to invite you guys into, because this is about your parents. They're the first round of people who get to experience this goodness. This is about your children who get to see generations to come. And it's about you as well. So this is something to where the Lord really placed in my heart for this John 3:16, something we've all heard plenty of times. It says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Everlasting life is the technology in the kingdom that we get to tap into. It doesn't have to be a chaotic end when we die and go to heaven. It gets to be a place that we get to transition into from peace and rest as we take care of our body and our physiology. So I say all this to say, we've got an amazing event all day Saturday on May 11th called Prayer Walker Live that I would love to encourage you guys to come on out to. The QR code's up there. You can scan it. You can grab me or my wife afterwards. What this is we're going to be prophesying into this, praying into this, commissioning people to help build this blue zone here, right here in our city, right here starting in our church. And we'll have a 5K that morning. Charity proceeds are going to help out the homeless teens here in the Cedar Hill School District. We're aiming to give 5K to those kids to be able to support them. And I would love for you guys to be a part of that. Your proceeds join this. So it'll be a whole weekend of health, Jesus, and a great time. So I'd love to have you there. Sammy, you got anything?
Yeah, if any of you guys have been feeling called on your heart that taking care of your health and nurturing your body is a very important piece, we're trying to segue that mission and lead that forward, because we know that your health is what allows you to pursue your mission at your greatest. So you might know what you're supposed to do, but you're tired or you feel exhausted, your body's holding you down. When you know the proper tools to take care of your physique, not the way that you look, but the way that you feel and the way that you function, that's what allows you to go out there and serve your greatest purpose. So we want to invite you guys to have that conversation, and come on.
That's so good. What you just said, some of you might even carry around cycles of depression and stuff like that. It might be what you're eating. You might be feeding yourself a constant diet of stuff that's causing inflammation in the body.
Yes.
And that can be taxing on you mentally and emotionally, and just, it's hard to move forward. So if you identify with any of that.
Come on.
Thank you guys so much. Yeah. This is awesome.
What's up, guys? I am Zach. I have the privilege of leading you guys into tithes and offerings. I'm going to read out of Malachi 3, verse 10. It says, "Bring the full tithe into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house. And thereby put me to the test, says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open the windows of heaven for you and pour down for you a blessing until there is no more need. I will rebuke the devourer for you so that it will not destroy the fruits of your soil, and your vine in the field shall not fail to bear, says the Lord of hosts. Then all nations will call you blessed, for you will be a land of delight, says the Lord of hosts. I've seen in my life countless and countless times again that as I continue to tithe and give the Lord a tenth of my income, that he continues to provide for me. And so I just challenge you guys to sow into this ministry, sow into Trinity Church, and watch the blessings that will come into your life. I'm going to pray. You can. There's going to be some people that are going to pass the buckets. And if you are technology savvy like myself, you can text TYA to 972-444-2113 or scan the QR code. As the buckets pass, if you would, just go ahead and stand up, and we're going to get back into worship. Dear Lord, I thank you for TYA, and I thank you for all of the generous hearts that are being pushed and challenged to begin to give and sow into this ministry. I ask that you bless them over and abundantly, and prepare our hearts for what the Lord is going to do tonight. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Why don't you stand with us? We're going to worship some more. We got more than one song in us, guys. Come on. Oh, pass the buckets. I see what's happening. My bad. I want to read to you Psalms 100. This is our verse that we were praying into as a team. Shout joyfully to the Lord and all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful singing. Know that the Lord himself is God. It is he who has made us, not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him. Bless his name. For the Lord is good. His loving kindness is everlasting, and his faithfulness to all generations. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to bless the Lord. We're going to come in with praise and thanksgiving, all right? So I just want you to lift up your hands. And right here, right now, just say, Lord, I'm here for you. We just say all over the room, Lord, we're here for you. We come in with praise and thanksgiving. We submit ourselves to your leadership, Lord, to your authorities. We come under everything that you want to do tonight, Lord. We put ourselves low so that you can go high. Song. Just tell him how you came in this room for him tonight. You didn't show up for a good worship song. You didn't show up for a good word. You came to meet with him. Just begin to sing out joyfully. Sing your own song. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord right here, right now.
Yeah, it doesn't have to be pretty. Just sing it out. Sing that again for you.
sing it one more time.
Come and let your presence fill our praise, fill our praise. Come and let your presence fill the...
One more time, come on.
Oh, come and let your presence fill our praise, fill our praise. Come and let your presence fill this place. 'Cause for you, all the world we want to meet, Jesus shine through. All the praises that we see,
didn't show up with a purpose, with intention, but we just change our minds right here, right now. We say that we are here for you, Lord. Would you move however you see fit tonight, God? We get out of the way that you can have your own way.
Worthy, the most worthy. temple, fill me with fire.
There's no one. praise goes high and high and high. Let the flame burn bright and bright and brighter as our praise goes high and high and high. Let the flame burn bright and bright and bright. Jesus, have my hopes, my dreams, my world. With joy I lay it down, with joy I cast my regrets. Jesus, have it all. To you I bring my praise, my lips, my song, a living sacrifice. As one reborn, your life is now my own, your will is what I want. Jesus, have it all. Jesus, have it all. Jesus, have it all. To you belongs the glory, the praise of all. Jesus, have it all. Jesus, have it all. Blessing and honor, majesty and all. Jesus, have it all. Jesus, have your church, your love, your bride, joyful. Jesus, have your way, your due, your soul.
So literally milliseconds before Vontae started singing this, that wasn't milliseconds, it was probably 10 seconds, this song started playing in my head. This is not what I'd planned on us doing right at this moment, but the fact that this song dropped into my heart and then he started singing it, I feel like there's something that was like, well, Lord, do you want there to be something surrendered tonight? And then Daniel walked up to me. Where'd you go, Daniel? I told you not to go far. I wasn't sure what needed to be surrendered, but just go ahead. And then he told me this.
I had this impression in my soul where I saw a dam that was broken and the water was just bursting out, like a lot of water. And I heard the Lord saying, I am unclogging what was holding back your worship, your praise. So praise is being released and unclogged in people's hearts.
And when he said dam, immediately what I heard in the spirit was damned. And I mean that in the curse, like to be damned, to be cursed. And I feel like what's about to happen now, what there's an opportunity for, is there are curses that have been over some of you, maybe your families. And that as I want us to go back into this worship, you can sing that if you want, I Surrender All or whatever. But I think there's a praise that needs to come out of you that you haven't felt the liberty to release. And in that, it's a curse-breaking praise. Does that make sense? Doesn't matter if it makes sense. When God's in the room, we just need to yield to it. Do you have something? Okay, come on, baby. I believed going into tonight that we were going to walk through some tall grass. Tall grass means that we're going places we've never been before. We're in the tall grass right now. So if you're like, well, I feel like we need more direction, they need to know what they're doing. We don't know. We know what we're yielding to, but that doesn't mean that we know where we're going.
So I believe that the New Testament church is supposed to look, and church services are supposed to look a little bit more organic than they often do in 2024. And that means that one would share a hymn, a spiritual song, an encouragement. And so at TYA, those of you that have been coming for a while, you know that we don't just do a normal service top to bottom, but we really are making room for the Holy Spirit to do whatever he wants to in our midst. And so earlier, Gabriel asked me a while ago, do you have anything? And earlier as we were worshiping, I'm going to ask everyone to go ahead and stand. Everyone stand. Earlier as we were worshiping, I felt like the Lord wanted to break out in your worship. I feel like the Lord wants to do something special in our midst tonight. And as he's going to move, we have about 45 minutes left together or so. And as the Lord is going to move, what I felt like the Lord wanted was 100% participation. And so in order for there to be 100% participation, something that we need to do together as a family and as a community is to declare war on a spectator mentality.
Come on.
And so very often, TYA, you come in here, and many of you are ready to worship, but a lot of times, a lot of you are just spectating. And as your mama, I'm calling you out on it tonight. And I believe that the Lord wants to take us somewhere together as a corporate unit. We come in as individuals and we are surrendering things in our lives, just as Daniel said. But then he said something about a dam breaking and our worship flowing in a special way tonight. And so in order for us to walk through the tall grass, meaning somewhere we've never been before, it's going to take each of us taking on the spirit of a pioneer. I was talking to Bree right before service about being a pioneer. And what do pioneers do? Pioneers blaze a path and they go in a direction that nobody else has ever gone before. And so as a community, we want to go somewhere in the spirit of God tonight. We're believing that there's going to be healings and signs and wonders and miracles. But right now, I just want to put a demand on you and those that are watching online in the spirit to take off any glasses that are just spectating or that are just here watching and saying, show me something, TYA. But that you come in and say, show me something, Holy Spirit. And so we need to, I don't think it's a coincidence. I still don't know the piece. Gabriel had, I surrender all in my spirit. And then Vontae, you began to sing that. So that's not a coinky dink, right? And so can we just all, just in the spirit of casting off spectatorism, is that a word? Yeah. Do something you've never done before. I want everyone just to close your eyes, and we're going to sing this song, and I want you just to surrender yourself to the Lord. Surrender your body to the Lord. Come on, begin to surrender even the thoughts that are going through your mind. Are you Lord of your life, or is Jesus Lord of your life? Are you Lord of even your worship, or is Jesus Lord of your worship? So come on, TYA, raise your hands. Let's surrender to His Lordship right now. And surrender, surrender. Surrender your personality. Surrender your preferences. Surrender the way you normally worship. And let's walk through the tall grass together. If you have a prayer language, just begin to pray in the Spirit. Come on.
Savior, I Yourself in worship, lead yourself, keep singing it.
A little bit more, press, press. We're about to move past this point into something else. Come on, intercessors. The word that keeps coming to mind is I want us to drill into the bedrock of what God is doing right now. Not even sure what that means, but we're going to a deeper place. We're breaking through places that you've never been before. If you have a spiritual language, I want you to engage that right now. And I don't want you to engage with passivity. I want you to engage, lean into it. Hell is so afraid that you're going to wake up and realize who you really are. In Jesus' name, revelation in the house tonight. Revelation of sonship. Revelation of rightful royalty to the King of all kings. Seramanda kase kiridi ambushata rana kase. Consider yourself a part of this house. I encourage you, please go and check it out, because we're going, God is taking us somewhere, and we are not going to go there ignorantly. I had the honor and privilege of being under one of my favorite humans on the planet under his teaching this weekend, Dutch Sheets. And those of you who were here last week, we covered a lot of ground, but we talked about when the disciples came to Jesus and said, "Would you teach us how to pray?" And the beginning of that is a statement that we hear a lot. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. But at some point in the church, we've gotten used to praying as if there are like limp suggestions. We just kind of toss it at the sky and hope for the best. And I did have a teaching that I wanted to give you tonight, and it was only 2,000 words long. God had something else in mind, but I do want to give you this much. And then those of you that are appointed for this next section that we discussed and that we're in prayer tonight, you would go ahead and come line up at the front here. In that passage, it's Luke chapter 11. It's right at the very top, verses 1 and 2, 3. When Jesus gave the outline of how to pray, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven, what Dutch Sheets taught this weekend that I got to hear, he said the verb tense in the Greek, any nerds in the house? Come on, let's give it up for the nerds. I love nerds. I am B1. It's actually, Dutch was one of the main influencers in my life to teach me how to actually get in the word and dig out meaning. And he said the verb tense in this scripture, it's not just a prayer, and it's certainly not just a your kingdom come someday, will be done at some point. It's the verb tense is a very, it's like an aggressive present tense application. What it's really saying is when you find a situation that's broken, it's like you pull heaven with both hands. I mean, because word says the violent take it by force, right? So you grab heaven with both hands and you throw it at the darkness. Your kingdom come. Your will be done here, right now. It is not a suggestion. It is a heavenly decree that you've been given charge to disperse in the earth, to disseminate, to dispense. It is your job, your right, your authority, your responsibility, all of that. As a child of God, it is not our place to go and just kind of wimply go, God, would you maybe please do something? That's not what He's designed us to do. Now, maybe current religion has taught us to do that and be that, but that's not who God, that's not who Jesus set as a standard for us to follow. So, what we're about to do, it's going to be new for us. How do I say this? I'm making it too complicated. Jared, come up here and give an outline of what's about to happen here.
All right. So in 1 Corinthians 12, Paul shows 9 spiritual gifts that he highlights for us as the church to use in order to display God's love to other people. And one of those gifts is a word of knowledge. So for those of you who don't know what that is, it's really simple. It's a word that God gives someone that gives them information that they wouldn't know about an individual in order that God's love can enter into that situation. Oftentimes we see that with healing. So God will speak to someone like our friends up here and say, give them something like, the Lord spoke to me about asthma today. I said, okay, Lord, what are you wanting to heal today? What are you wanting to restore today? Where do you want to bring your kingdom today? And he told me asthma. So God revealed that to me so that we could release that into the atmosphere so that when he's targeting asthma today.
Papa Bill, just come on up here.
Awesome. So God highlights that because he wants to display his love through his spiritual gifts as it talks about in 1 Corinthians 13. So that's what everyone up here has done. They've taken a moment with the Lord and said, Jesus, what is something that's on your heart that you want to break through today in someone's life? So our friends up here are going to share what God put on their heart, and then we're going to get around, and the prayer team, not these guys, you guys, are going to intercede and pray for these things that we really believe are on God's heart, so he can display his love, his power, and his authority in those situations for healing, for restoration for individuals.
Awesome. We'll give a little bit more instruction, but first we want to release these words of knowledge into the atmosphere, and we'll go from there.
One thing is knee pain. Another thing I got is heart palpitations or a rapid heart rate or chest pain. And I feel like there's someone potentially with that symptom that's unsure if it's a physical issue or like panic attacks, but either way, there's healing available for your body and your mind.
All right. Anybody identify any of those? Struggle with any, knee pain, panic attacks? Raise your hand. Come on. This is a safe place. This is, if you can't do it here, you can't do it anywhere. Awesome. All right. Good. All right. Awesome. Next.
Okay, first I want to say there's no shame or condemnation in Christ. And I was asking the word for the Lord, and he said, speak from your testimony. And so I want to speak to sin patterns of sexual immorality. Okay, we're too scared to say it in the church. Oh, I had an addiction to pornography and masturbation, and part of it is speaking it out. If you don't say it, how can we pray it? How can we help you? How can we partner with you? And something that the Lord specifically told me to say was, some of you have come into such hatred towards your sin, but you're still stuck in it. And we need to pray against vices, against the principalities attached to the sin.
All right. I don't know if anybody wants to raise their hand to that. You have to be vulnerable, but understand there is freedom. There is freedom in the house. Yes. All right. Very good. Very good.
All right, so the Lord was revealing to me, anybody with chronic migraines, whether it be from a childhood injury, whether it's genetic, whatever it is, chronic migraines, and anemic, so low iron, if you're constantly cold, if you're struggling with that, that's what I got.
Very good. All right, anybody? All right. Okay, awesome, very good.
I have a few things. The first being, I felt like the Lord wanted to heal people of crippling anxiety. Another thing that I got is someone believing salvation for a sister, specifically maybe like 13, teenage year. Another one was scoliosis and misaligned spines. And then for TYA worship, I just felt like the Lord took me to Psalms 27 and 8. And it says, some nations boast in their chariots and horses, but we boast in the name of the Lord our God. And for that, those nations will fall and collapse, but we will rise and stand firm. And I just feel like he wanted to let you know that to the pure, all things are pure. And so there are not limitations on the ways that y'all can be creative when you're leading us in worship. More specifically, Walker, I felt like the Lord said, no person has heard the place of worship that I'm planning to take you. And that he is in awe of the way you steward the gifts that he has given you.
Wow, that is beautiful. That's beautiful. Hold on one second. What were the healings again? I can't remember what they were.
Crippling anxiety, scoliosis and misaligned, and then salvation for a sister.
Okay, anybody identify with any of those in the house? Okay, very good. Oh, wow. This is awesome.
That is so funny. So yeah, I got crippling anxiety as well, literally right after Matt. And then also I got right knee pain in this area. It's like a kind of like a clicking kind of thing, kind of nagging. And then I also got lower right back pain as well, just kind of like a tightness in the muscles. But then also I got right back plate pain as well. So like the Lord was saying, like there's like limitation of mobility, being able to be moved. And then also double-mindedness is what came to me as well. I'm just shooting out there, sorry. All right, so Princess, I kept hearing the name Princess, Precious, something, Priscilla, something like that. And I feel like the Lord, I don't know if there's somebody here maybe, but I feel like the Lord is saying that he values you as his daughter. You are a queen. And then the last thing is this couple over here, the Lord highlighted you guys to me. You guys are Mighty in the Kingdom of God. And in specifics to you guys will have a great family and great nation out of you guys specifically. And I don't know if you guys are have children already or not. Okay, and I feel like the Lord is saying that he's going to begin to move in the area of fertility for you guys as well. So opening your womb. I don't know if that's, okay, there you go. So opening her womb. Lord God, I thank you right now for opening our womb in Jesus' name. Lord God, I thank you that you are the one who opens all wombs. God, any imbalances in the muscles, any imbalances in her body, her hormones, Lord, we call it into alignment right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Thank you.
All right, so we had knee pain in the right knee specifically and lower back on the right side and decreased mobility in the upper back. Anybody have any of those things? Okay. Yeah, absolutely. She's marked territory right there. All right.
I had reoccurring migraines, mental health disorders, specifically depression, but let's go after all of them. Yeah. Heart issues, someone already said that. And the Lord downloaded to my heart autoimmune disorders and diseases and night terrors.
Okay. Anybody? This is like a shopping list. Let's go shopping. Let's get everything that the land paid for, okay?
I specifically heard the phrase chains of depression, specifically attached to shame. I saw a picture of like chains around your head that was preventing you from seeing the correct perception of your life. And I also heard plantar fasciitis, which is something to do with your feet and pain.
Nerve pain in the feet.
Yeah.
All right, anybody? Also, if you know somebody directly related to you, you're allowed to claim that prize for them as well.
I have been praying today, and I just feel like there are people in the room that are worried about the future, fear of future, and even doubt. Doubt in God, doubt in your situation because you don't feel like anything is happening. You're just kind of like, okay, well, this is what it is. God has more for you. And yeah, he has more for you.
Wonderful. Anybody? Anybody want to say, yeah, I sign up for that? Okay.
I just got, if you are having bad dreams or you cannot sleep at night, it's so hard. Even you wake up in the middle of the night and it's a nightmare. And the other thing is just like family. You're contending for someone from your family, even you don't know them and you wanted to be close to Jesus, I think.
Okay. Night terrors, sleeplessness, anxiety in the night hours, yeah? Okay.
I felt the Lord highlighting the ones who are feeling trouble-minded, specifically because facing an unexpected hardship or difficulty and now are asking, like, why is this happening? And It is leading you to a point of even being wounded by the sense of lack of answers and direction. And then there's all of this pressure of all of this heaviness in your spirit.
Anybody? Okay. Very good. Oh, there's going to be so much freedom tonight.
Woo. Hey, so I was sensing mental warfare. It was like these things that were attacking your mind consistently, and you would experience breakthrough, and then like you would find yourself in a place of like, why is this happening to me again? And I believe the Lord is speaking for those cycles to be broken, not just over your life, but over your bloodline. So I believe the Lord is breaking off cycles of mental warfare and bringing peace to storms. And I'm just gonna step out and say this one more thing. Ramses, the Lord's been just speaking so much about who you are and empowering you. And I just believe so strongly that the Lord is depositing a strong discipleship anointing upon your life. There's something that the Lord is doing on the inside of you that is like literally going to, it already has begun, it's shifting, but what he's gonna begin to do is gonna highlight and give you understanding and revelation of the scripture like never before, where you will speak, empower, and disciple young men and those around you into deeper places. And this is not just for friend groups, this is for your family as well, so.
So good. Okay, so you feel stuck in cycles. You like, you find breakthrough, but the breakthrough doesn't sustain. So we're pressing in for sustained breakthrough. And we were in prayer earlier tonight. Jared also was praying over sin cycles. And I got a word. I just typed out a word from the Lord real quick. But the word was relocation and moving from sin cycles to signs and wonders. So what we're about to engage in here in just a little bit, I don't care if you cussed somebody out on your way to church tonight or what your history is. We're about to do this together, and we're going to watch you who have thought the enemy has told you your whole life, you're stuck in this cycle. This is not just how it is. This is who you are. Broken. We're going to break that cycle. We're going to move you from sin cycles to signs and wonders tonight, okay?
I kept seeing like there was a spot on someone's brain, and I don't know if that is specifically like something that you've been diagnosed with or a concern that you have, like maybe there's something happening in your brain, or like one of the glands, like the pineal or pituitary gland. But specifically that. And then I also heard the word diverticulitis, which is an inflammation of the large intestine, so like stomach, digestive issues. Also, I saw when we were in prayer earlier, someone's back, and I'll try to show you where, but like right here in the middle area, like where your shoulder blades come together. I saw it wasn't just like a physical issue. I don't know if someone has like a plate, like a metal plate, or if it's just like a resemblance that there's literally something like a lock or tension like in your back right there. But it's also connected to like something that the enemy's had like a literal target on your back too. So you feel the pressure of that. So, yeah.
Wonderful. Anybody? Any of those things? Spot on the brain. Again, if you know somebody, maybe somebody in your family, you can claim it for them. We'll go into prayer here in a second.
Just as I came up here, I saw the picture, and we've all seen it at the Olympics where they open up a cage and all of these birds, doves, fly out. And I just felt, and even earlier when we prayed, I said, tonight, the cage is going to be open.
Come on, yes, Lord.
I felt like shame and regret has encaged you, and you just feel like you can't fly. And tonight, I believe there's such an anointing of freedom here in all of these areas.
Yeah, there is.
That there's going to be such an opening, and you're going to fly and soar like you never have before. And I pray against all shame. It is a work of the enemy. And you have been agreeing with that. And it's about time you say, I disagree with the shame that the enemy has forced me to consider. And others have spoken about that. And you have agreed with it. And I'm saying in the name of Jesus, cages be open in Jesus' name. We're about to fly in freedom. Secondly, and that's generally, but secondly, there is somebody that last week, a family member just said some things to you, a very close family member, and it happened either Wednesday or Thursday of last week, and you felt like someone jabbed a dagger in your heart, and you have just crumbled. And God is saying, I'm about, because of forgiveness, because of releasing them in the name of Jesus and experience the love of the Lord, right now in the name of Jesus, this dagger comes out of you in the name of Jesus. The dagger just comes out of you. You are healed in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name. Okay, so anyone, you felt caged and you're ready to come into disagreement, again, very clear, you come into disagreement with shame and all of that junk. That could be pretty much everybody in the whole room. We're ready to be uncaged, unlocked. All right. So, okay, Holy Spirit, how do you want to do this? Let's lay some ground rules. If you identified with anything that needs healing, okay, there were some other things that were announced tonight. Like the sexual repetitive sin and some things like that. I want to save that for later. But if there's anything that was a healing, like a knee pain, the back, all that kind of stuff, if you identified with any of those or you claimed any of those for a family member, I want you to stand up and raise your hand so we can see where you are. Raise your hand. Okay. Now, the rest of you who are not, you don't have your hand raised, look around. They are your coordinates. You have been deputized by the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ to bring his manifest kingdom, which brings order to everything that is in chaos, and that includes sickness and disease. I want ladies with ladies, guys with guys, ask permission before you lay hands on them. If it's a part of their body that's okay for you to lay hands on, please do that. I want you to ask them what it is that we're praying for. Those of you who are getting prayer, don't go into a whole long story. Just give us the facts. What are we going after? And tell them what your pain level is. Knee pain, whatever it is, it's like, well, it right now I think it's kind of like an 8 out of 10 pain level. Okay, and now those of you that are praying, don't pray yet. Hold on a second. I want you to speak to the ailment. Speak to the broken thing. You don't have to use a whole lot of words. You say, sickness, I curse you in Jesus' name. And I command the kingdom of God to be made manifest through this healing right now in Jesus' name. It's very simple. Okay, go. You have the authority to do this. The enemy spends a lot of time trying to talk us out of the authority that we already have. Right, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, ask them. Test it out. If it's, have them try to do something they couldn't do before. And we're looking for improvement. Sometimes it's all of it comes instantaneously. Sometimes it's a process. What do they got? Anybody got? Anybody 100% better? Anybody yet? Do we need to go in for round two? We can do that. That's okay. Jesus healed a blind man. The first prayer, men look like trees. So we gave him another dose. It's okay to go for seconds. Where are we? What does that mean? Okay, come here.
My right knee is in a car accident. Pain went away for a long time. It recently came back when I popped my knee out of place. And so I literally wake up in the middle of the night recently to pain and popping and whatnot. And there's no popping. Like there's no.
So you're healed.
There's no popping. And yeah. No pain. There's no popping or pain.
Come on. If God is doing one kind of miracle in the room, he's doing all kinds of miracles in the room. Anybody else? All right, if they need more breakthrough, then go again. We got something crazy right here. What, Jeremiah? Tell us what's happening.
I was asking him to pray for my chest, and I had a lot of, I feel great. Like, that's crazy. I have a lot of chest pain, and less like,
had
a lot of chest pain, and like, gout and stuff like that. It just feels great right now. I prayed the first time and it wasn't that much better, but now it's like.
And then what's interesting, so we tested it. This was cool. So we tested it. Nothing happened the first time and we were like, well, that's cool. Jesus prayed. Like, we'll pray again. So we did it, and then correct me if I'm wrong, but after the second time, nothing had happened physically, and he tested it and you went up like this, and it was almost like a pop or a release. It just feels
like everything's good. Like, it's kind of crazy.
So after you test, it's when you tested it that it,
the manifestation, the healing occurred. That's biblical. That's what the Lord healed the lame man, said, get up and walk. So you got to put action to the faith, right? Anybody else? Yes, ma'am.
Her knees, my mom's knees, and her feet was hurting when I last talked to her. And she says she feels good now. No pain in her knees, no pain in her feet.
Mama was healed. I speak healing over your mamas in Jesus' name. What have we been saying for the last few months? We're going to make you guys dangerous. You know what scares hell? Scares hell out of hell? You learning how to use the authority that you have. What do we have over here? What's going on? Back? Yeah? Tell me what was it before?
So for context, I was in a bad car accident. Me and my family, we got rear-ended by a drunk driver, and I was diagnosed with a herniated disc in my spine. Every time I would lift something heavy, sit down for too long, stand up for too long, I would just get really bad back pain. And I'm trying to lift these chairs right now. Normally, I would feel a sharp pain on my lower right side of my back, but I don't really feel that anymore, I'm gonna be honest.
We like honesty, especially when healing is involved. Amen. Come on, celebrate that. Here's the thing. Listen to this. We have to learn to celebrate every type of healing that comes, whether it's brain cancer or an ingrown toenail. The reason being is because in each one of these situations, the Creator interacted with created. And that's a big deal. And we always celebrate anything that he's lifting two chairs right now. No pain. Come on. All right. Cool. I love this so much. I know we're going to have more testimonies as we go. Now he's doing squats with chairs. Get healed so you can come help us move chairs. How many of you prayed for anybody in public this last week? Remember we talked about that last week. Anybody? Any hands go up? 1, 2, all right, 3, 4, 5, okay, 6, 7, all right, and next week it's going to be even more, because you have the authority to go to every dark, broken place and do exactly this. And let me tell you this encouraging story. This guy felt like he had a prophetic word for a stranger on the street. And went up and gave this stranger this word, like he thought he was giving him a word of knowledge. And he asked the guy, "Is that, you identify with any of that?" And the guy was like, "No, you're way off. Nothing that you said connects." So this guy gave a prophetic word and completely, utterly blew it. Well, then the next week, the guy that gave the prophetic word was at church, because he told him what church he went to and all stuff. And the guy that was like, "No, you totally blew that. Nothing, none of this means anything to me," he brought his whole family to church. To the church where the guy that of the guy that blew the prophetic word, the word of knowledge. And he's like, "Why are you here?" He said, "Basically, I mean, the word that you gave me did not apply to me, but you cared enough to try to give it to me. I thought, if that church has people that care that much to try to reach me, then I want to bring my whole family." So look, to obey is better than sacrifice. We're not looking for perfection. We're looking for willingness. That's all he wants. That's all he wants. All right, Holy Spirit. What do you want to do? Ramses, come up here. This guy. This guy is a picture of personal revival.
tell them what God did in your heart.
Hi. I'd heard about God. I'd been in the church my whole life. I was kind of like, I knew him through my parents. And like, I'm even on the worship team, which is crazy. I was just living a life completely separate from him. And then coming and playing, and it was bad. And I got so desperate. And one day, I just got on my knees in my room, and I cried out. And he encountered me in such a powerful way. And here I am today.
We went out to lunch a couple of weeks ago. Within 30 seconds, he was pouring out to me everything he's ever done that he wasn't proud of. He's like, I want to know the word. I want to know God. I want to understand it. I want to give my whole life. How do I do that? What do we need to do? So we come out here in the morning, Tuesdays and Thursdays. We just hang out with the Lord at 7 o'clock. I'm not inviting you, but I'm not going to say no either. And I'm telling you, God is on the move. In fact, last week, when we came together, first thing in the morning, he walked into my office and made some coffee real quick. And first thing out of his mouth was, bro, I don't know. God's on the move. He's doing something. I don't know what he's doing, but he's doing something. I want you to just pray over them that what happened to you will happen to them. But you got to receive it. Listen, 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 listen. Look at Linda. Look at. Stand up. Very often in services, Holy Spirit is dispensing fresh graces and mercies. And we think just by being in the room that we're going to get it. It's up to you to grab hold of it. The image that comes to mind, have you ever seen anybody in one of those glass box things and they turn this fan on and then money starts flying around and they have to grab all the, like, $100 they can? A lot of people come to church like that and they just stand there. Oh, look, I'm surrounded by all this cash. It's just flying around. And they walk out and wonder why they're poor, because you didn't grab it. That's good. All right. Rams is going to pray for you.
I pray that you just tender our hearts to you, Lord, that we look to you as you're all we need, Lord. Just fresh encounter, Lord.
Yes, God.
New wine, Lord. We're so desperate for you, Lord. May we lay it all down for you, Lord. Yeah. You're all we need. Consume us, Lord.
Father, we receive your hunger and appetite for things not of this world. Come on, you can self-medicate all you want, but you're filling a hole that can only be filled by him.
We're not going to linger much longer, but I feel like there's one or two more things that need to be unlocked.
When Ramses was praying, he just heard the cry of his heart, crying out to be consumed by God. And I just began to say, God, I'm hungry. I just feel that cry coming out. And I just think we just need to cry out. Like, you just need to cry out for your own heart. Just begin to raise your hands and ask the Lord to make you hungry. Come on, don't wait for me to lead you. Ask God to make you hungry. Come on, cry out for an encounter with Jesus. Come on, TYA, grab it, grab it, grab it. God, I'm so hungry for you, God. Will you fill me, Jesus? Come on, cry out to Jesus. Cry out to Jesus. Tell him that you want him. Tell him that you're hungry. Ask him to make you hungry. Oh, would you fill me, fill me, fill me? I need fresh oil. I need fresh oil, God. I'm
come
so
on,
hungry.
One last push. One last push. If you're hungry, just come down front. Just come on down. Come on down. Come on, let's put our feet on this hunger. Come on, come forward if you want to move into the next realm of hunger for the Lord. Breakthrough. Leave the old cycles behind.
We know there's more. We want it all. We want it all. We want it all. We want it all, Jesus.
Nothing left behind. Jared is going to give us a little bit of direction that I think some of you have been on the outside, not feeling welcomed into this process of what's happening. Jared.
Yeah, I heard the Lord ask the question, do you know me? And I felt like there was a call to encounter and a call to salvation and repentance, to really know him. Just as Ramses had that experience, I felt like there was a call, and the Lord's asking the question, do you know me? So if you can't answer that question, yes, I know you, I want you to come to the front and just kneel down.
Yeah, come right down here, and right here down in the front and center. Come on. Take that step.
Yeah. And God's going to encounter you in a really powerful way. Do you know him? Do you know him? Do you know him? Do you know who we were singing about? Do you know who we were talking about? Do you know him? And I'm going to say a sentence, and I just want you all to repeat after me. And then from there, we're just going to have a couple of our ministry people pray over you. So if you're on the ministry team, you want to come forward. I want you to repeat after me. Say, Jesus, I want to know you. It's that simple. So Holy Spirit, I thank you for every individual up here who is surrendering their lives to you. Lord, we release the power of your Holy Spirit over every single person who's giving their yes right now to you. Jesus, we want to know you. We want to see you rightly. We want to know this King of Kings and Lord of Lords who rules over the earth. We want to know you personally, God. So Holy Spirit, pierce the hearts of these individuals who are giving a big yes to you. A surrendering moment, an important moment to say, yes, I will lay my life down for you. Jesus, 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 King of Kings, reveal yourself. Reveal yourself to your children. We want to know you, Lord. We don't just want to know about you. We want to know you, the person Jesus, the man who died on the cross for every stupid thing we've ever done. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Fill our hearts. Fill our hearts. Thank you, Lord.
Let's just give this a couple more moments. You can sing over it. You haven't forgotten about those other words of knowledge that were given about cycles and things like that. Pray over that shortly, but I want to give this just a little bit more time to marinate.
Beyond the glory, beyond the honor and the praise, beyond the glory, beyond the honor and the praise, beyond the glory, beyond.
says you're unlocked tonight. Something brand new. Something you've been looking for, waiting for. He said, okay, now, mija, now's the time. All right, we had a lot of other words of knowledge that were given that weren't specific to physical healings. If you remember what yours were, I need my prayer team. Let's do these aisles. Let's do this. A healing? Najoni, I know she had a sling on earlier. Tell us what happened.
So on Good Friday, I got in a car accident. Someone drove right into my driver door. And since my accident, they first told me that I injured my AC joint, so the main part of my shoulder that connects into my collarbone, and pain would just pierce into my upper back and into my neck. And Kristen's word, where she said where there was just pain in the middle of someone's back, that was me. For the past 2 weeks since my accident, I haven't had any release of pressure in the middle of my back. And it was so bad that I couldn't sleep for the last 2 weeks because every time I'd lay on my back, it would just pierce from literally the middle of my back to my whole left shoulder. And I came over to her for prayer, and I can move my shoulder, which this morning I wasn't able to do.
Come on!
So, yeah, so... there's no pressure in the middle of my back. I wasn't even able to lift my arm up this morning. Yes! And so complete healing.
Here, you can take this. Come on! Look what God is doing! And who is he using? All of you. Because this is what you were born to do. Where was I? Okay, I need my prayer team down this aisle and then some of you over here. That'd be great. So if you identified with any of the other words of knowledge that were given, it's about like praying for like a lost sibling, and there was a few things, breaking cycles and things like that. You can find any of my leaders on either side here. Or anything else. Maybe there's something else tonight that you would like someone to stand with you in regards to or whatever. Those of you who received prayer tonight for healing, let me give you some keys as well. From this point forward, we're looking for the healing, okay? We're not looking for symptoms of sickness, because the enemy of your soul would love to rob that seed of healing from you. So the way you combat that is to keep speaking the word of the Lord over that place. And then watch, maybe even by tomorrow morning, tomorrow evening, that thing is going to progressively get better. Amen? Amen? Three of you. Okay. That'll be all right. All right, any other announcements? Anything else I need to say? Canes. Group is going to Canes. Chris, are you going to the Family Starts here? Awesome. All right, if you are new tonight, if this is your first time, anybody first time? We didn't give. Oh my goodness, look at you guys. Come on. Wow, that's so great. Okay, the flashing sign there in the back. My friend Chris Pina, he's over there, and he would love to meet you. We have a gift for you. I'd like to get to know you so we can honor and serve and burn together. Ramsey and I will be in this room at 7 o'clock in the morning if anybody wants to come out and join us. Right in here. I don't know. Is the Lord good? Did he do something tonight? Some of you, for the first time, yeah. Let me share this. Mr. Jeremy King came up and told me, he said that he saw a lot of you like have been reoccurring, battling these giants in your life, and that tonight you cut the head off of that giant, and the Lord was smiling and celebrating over you. He was so thrilled at your freedom. So congratulations, you're free. You're also free to go. May the Lord bless you and keep you, cause his face to shine upon you and give you grace and peace now through the end of all eternity with the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.